What's up, everybody? Alan Tyler here for episode 3 of ATGHG Beer Tasting. I can't believe it's already episode 3. So let's get started. Time for the first beer. All right, so I've got here the LA Woman Kolsch from Georgetown Brewing. I know we recently did a Georgetown beer. We've had a couple of theirs on recently. I'm a big fan. They always do really good beers. And this is their summer-released Kolsch. Now, I didn't already look the information up on this, so we get to examine it together. Part-time beer from Georgetown Brewery. They list it on their website as a darn tasty Kolsch, which I think is pretty accurate. I like that. 4.9% alcohol, 22 IBU. Both of those are definitely in the range of a pretty traditional Kolsch. Fun fact, a traditional Kolsch can only be brewed in the city of Cologne in Germany. But over here in the US, since we're not under German laws for beer, we can call it our own Kolsch. But a traditional Kolsch only comes from Cologne in Germany. Fun fact. Let's give it a shot. Nice clear, light gold color, very, very white head. I love Kolsch. Subtle, very, very subtle fruitiness, but a nice, bready, crackery kind of malt aroma. Maybe even a little bit of wheat. I think a Kolsch traditionally has a bit of wheat to it, so that kind of comes through. It smells great. Nice, clean body, kind of a touch of sweetness, a little bit of fruitiness on the back end. Bitterness is very, very low. It's not a bitter beer at all. And that's part of what makes it super, super drinkable. It keeps you coming back for more. This one, previous batches, I think it's had a little bit heartier body. This one seems a little bit thin, but it's also been well over a year since I've had this the last time. And this may just be how it always was. But ultimately, a super, super drinkable beer. Very light, very refreshing. These are perfect for sitting outside on the patio on a hot day. And summer just arrived here in Portland, so this is a perfect beer for it. Quite nice. I'm a big fan. Georgetown does great beers, and the LA Woman Kolsch is fantastic. It's currently on tap number 9 here at the shop. It's got a decent amount left. This keg's probably 3/4 full, at least halfway full. It's been on for a little bit. But now that the sun came out, I'm expecting it to go quite a bit faster. So, time for the next beer. All right, beer number 2 for today is the Lush IPA from Fremont Brewing. Also out of Seattle, happy to be a Seattle beer today. So this, before we even look anything up on it, I was about to do that. Let's go ahead and do the whole tasting process without knowing anything about it, and then we can find the details later. How's that sound? So once again, these are very, very similar. It's almost an even lighter gold, but a pretty hearty gold. Very clear beer, very clean. Nice kind of off-white head, very fine bubbles. Pretty usual, pretty standard. Ooh, big juicy fruity aromas, very pungent. Again, a lot of those tropical fruits, those are super, super popular right now from the hot varieties. I'm gonna guess Mosaic. There's gotta be a classic Cascade Chinook, one of those in there as well. I'm guessing, but pretty sure. Oh, really, really, a little bit of pininess as well. So really, really beautiful aroma, very enticing. I think very, very like hits the style for a West Coast IPA at this point in time. Plenty of lingering bitterness, but not overly bitter. Still very, very well balanced. A little bit of sweetness kind of on the palate, and then ends with the bitterness. It's kind of still hanging out. I can still experience it this many seconds later. Nice fruitiness on the palate as well. A little bit of a malt body character to it that again helps kind of carry that. That's where that sweetness is coming through. But there's a lot more fruit in the aroma, I would say. Fruitiness in the nose than there is on the actual palate. On the palate, it's a little more of that classic IPA. Just there's that bitterness on the back end, a little bit of sweetness to carry it through. But very, very nice IPA. I think anybody that's a fan of West Coast IPAs, which is most of the ones that you're gonna find in the Portland area right now, this is right up your alley. the Fremont Brewery, this was not their standard flagship IPA. It's still not their standard flagship IPA, but they did this, I believe, as a one-off or a seasonal a year or two ago, and it was so popular that they decided to bring it back and do it all the time. So fortunately, that means that we can get it more regularly. So let's actually look up some details on it, if we can. All right, the Lush IPA, 7% alcohol and 80 IBU. Citra and Mosaic hops along with Citra powder, so not even pellets. I'm guessing that's actually a new way of processing hops that I'm not actually familiar with. People are doing all sorts of things with hops now. They're freezing them in liquid nitrogen. They're creating sort of hop oils out of them by running different chemicals through them. All these sorts of chemical processes to extract as many of those delicious aromas, oils, flavors out of the hops. So I think that there's a lot of experimentation with hop varieties themselves, and the people are hybridizing them, creating new varieties and all of that. But now they're really experimenting with different ways to process and extract those different goodies out of those varieties. So that lupulin powder, I'm gonna have to look that up. I don't actually know what that is. They're saying tropical hops reminiscent of lime, mango, and guava. I was kind of getting that tropical fruit side of things. I didn't really pick up any lime or citrus. Maybe that's what I'm experiencing some of that bitterness as, is actually a bit of a kind of acidity or tartness from there's not actually lime added to it, I want to make that clear, it's just from the hop varieties, but I'm not really getting that in the aroma. I think it's just the bitterness that I'm experiencing today. So once again, that's the Lush IPA from Fremont Brewery out of Seattle. That's on tap number 5 here at Garden Home Growlers at the moment. And this keg just went on yesterday, this week. So it should be around for a bit, but again, with the temperature getting warmer and this nice juicy IPA, it'll probably sell through really quick. So once again, the IPAs or the beers for today, we have the Georgetown Brewery LA Woman Kolsch and the Fremont Brewery Lush IPA. So both on tap now. Thank you for checking it out, and we'll chat soon. Cheers.